If you want to be streaming to Instagram Live using Ecamm Live, then you came to the right tutorial. Instagram has opened Instagram Live Producer to all professional accounts, which includes both business and creator accounts. And if you don't have that type of account yet, don't worry. I'm going to show you how to change that. Instagram Live Producer allows you to stream using programs like Ecamm Live, so you can have multiple cameras, you can use external microphones, you can add graphics, like all sorts of stuff. You can make your stream look really good. And this means you can level up your Instagram Live and really stand out from the crowd. Like, people's live streams aren't looking like this if they're streaming from their phone. Using Ecamm, you can stream to multiple platforms at the same time, and you can even bring up your comments across platforms into the stream, which is the best. It really helps your audience feel like they're part of the show because they literally become part of your show. And I'm here to help you set it up. Now, before we get started, you got to make sure you have the latest version of Ecamm Live. In Ecamm, you're going to head to Preferences, General, and Check for Updates. And if you don't have Ecamm yet, welcome. Follow the link in the description and give it a try. It's really going to rock your world, I'm telling you. Next, let's make sure you have a professional Instagram account. In addition to that, your account needs to be linked to a Facebook page. Don't worry, it's easy to check. It's easy to set up. Now grab your phone and let's do this. Head to your profile page, and if you see professional dashboard, you already have a professional account. If you head to edit profile and under page, you see that a page is connected, you're good to go. You can skip to the next section. If you need to set it up, head to your profile, click on the three lines in the corner, go to settings and privacy, and then you can scroll down to for professionals. Here you'll see account type and tools. And this is where you can set up your professional account. Follow the prompts and it'll get you set up. Don't get too stressed about everything in here. You can definitely change all this stuff later. If your page is private, it's not going to work. If you want to have a professional account, it has to be public. Now you should have professional dashboard on your profile. If you go to edit profile, go down to where it says page. If you tap on that, you can either connect a page or create a page. Make sure this page is connected to your Facebook account. Not just any old Facebook account. It has to be your account. Now that we have that set up, let's head to the computer so we can access Instagram Live Producer and Ecamm Live. Head to your Ecamm preferences and let's add some destinations. If you go to add new destination and you go straight to Instagram, you're going to see that there's not a lot of things you can do here. First, you have to add your Facebook account. When you choose Facebook, Ecamm is going to prompt you to log in and it's going to connect to your Facebook profile page. It's going to give you the option to choose where to Facebook you want to stream. I just leave this alone because I don't actually stream to Facebook, but you need to have it connected in order for streaming to Instagram to work correctly. Now we can add Instagram as a destination. When you select Instagram, you'll see that there are some options you can choose from here. Pick the Instagram account that you want to stream to. Now it's time to set up a new broadcast. Click on New, and here you will see where you can add your destinations. Press Add, and you'll be able to see your Instagram account has been added as an option. Click on the pencil and you can double check your server URL and you can make sure you have the correct account selected. On your Instagram page that you've logged into on your desktop, you're going to go to Create, which is this little plus sign. And then you're going to choose Live. Here you can add a title and you'll want to choose Public. Then click Next. Here's the vital information for your live stream. In Ecamm, click on the pencil to edit your Instagram destination. Here's your server URL, the streaming URL. The first time you're setting up, you definitely want to copy and paste your stream URL into Ecamm. And your stream key, you're going to have to copy and paste every time you go live with Instagram Live Producer. You can choose to go live now, or you can add additional destinations. But know if you schedule a stream ahead of time with a thumbnail and description, that's not going to do anything for Instagram. That's just going to be for the other destinations. When you press Go Live in Ecamm, your other destinations will be live immediately. But Instagram is still going to be in preview mode in this preview window in Live Producer. It usually takes about 10 seconds for mine to connect where I can see the preview. So give it a second, but do know whatever other destination you have connected, they are live. They are public. People can see it. But in Instagram, it's not going to be public until you press the Go Live button in Instagram Live Producer. While this isn't live to Instagram right now, it is being recorded in your archive. So if you repost directly from your archive, it's going to have all of this stuff from before you go live. So keep that in mind. And when you're ready, press Go Live in Instagram Live Producer. Once you're live, you'll have a window where you can see your comments and you can also add comments yourself within Instagram. But there are limitations. A lot of the fun things you can do with Instagram Live on your phone, you can't do here. You're not going to see likes, but you're going to be able to see your view count, but you won't be able to see who is viewing, and you can't add guests in Instagram Live Producer. You can't use the questions feature in Instagram Live Producer. All you really get is what you brought into the stream using Ecamm Live. If you have more than one destination, when the comments come in, you'll see that there are different icons next to the different platforms. This way you can tell where they're coming from. When you're ready to end it, I recommend ending in Ecamm first, then waiting for it to go dark in Instagram Live Producer before you press end live video there. I had a situation where I accidentally ended my live stream in Ecamm, but I did not end it in Instagram Live Producer. If you still have your stream key, you can join back in on the live stream. So that's something to keep in mind. But I do think that this stream key only lasts for 5 hours from when you first create it. Cool, right? Before I send you on your way, there's a few things that you need to keep in mind. Most people on Instagram are going to see your stream as 9x16 vertical, especially if they're watching on their phone, but your stream can be 16x9 landscape. As long as you keep in mind that, you need to really focus most of your stream to this area here in the middle. Luckily, we now have a vertical safe zone feature in Ecamm to show us where we need to be, where we need to stay. And this is something that you're only going to see in your production window. It's not going to be pushed out to the live stream. So you don't have to worry about it. You can just keep it on. I keep it on all the time because I'm never in the middle. I'm always off to the side. And I have to remember, back to the middle. Very helpful. I personally stream in 16x9 landscape to both YouTube and Instagram at the same time. YouTube will see the whole scene. Some Instagram users, depending on where they're watching, can see the whole scene. I personally have not been able to find that. I've seen screenshots, so I know it's real. But most people on Instagram are only seeing this part here in the middle, so I try to keep most of the action in there. Keep it centered in here and on the stream. If you want your stream to be the same across all platforms, you can change your format in Ecamm to 9x16 vertical. So your live stream will be vertical. It'll just be this slice, this little slice in the middle, but do know that not all platforms will accept that format. So far, I've successfully streamed in vertical to YouTube, Facebook, and of course, Instagram. Now let's talk about the tech specs. This is what Instagram currently recommends, but I'll tell you that I've streamed out in 1080p at 25 frames per second, and it's never been an issue. I think Instagram just does the thing to make it work. Hasn't been a problem. Another thing I suggest you set up is your archive in Instagram. At the end of your stream, Instagram is going to ask if you want to discard the video. If you have your archive set up before you go live, it's going to be in there even though you press discard. But I'll tell you that I usually find that my files are a little bit wonky in there anyway, so I don't trust the archive. I just always set up my stream to record in Ecamm while I'm streaming at the same time. Everybody's happy. And that way I know I have a good copy for repurposing. Just waiting for me to cut into these little clips, all these juicy little clips to post across the internet. Juicy little clips. It might seem like a lot, but once you have all of this set up, you're going to be good to go and ready to live stream to Instagram using Ecamm Live. If you have any questions, please let us know and tell me in the comments what your live stream is about. I love to hear about it. I'm Mary Lou Mandel, wishing you the best on your live streaming journey. Until next time, see ya.